Hi, everybody. It's Kat. It's Kat's Clubhouse. And today is Tuesday, June 14th, which is also known as Flag Day. And today we're going to be making these fun little envelope pockets that attach to a journal page if you want them to, or they can be freestanding. And I'm going to change my camera now and show you what I'm talking about. Okay, so here we are, my messy desk. But I was having fun trying to figure stuff out this morning. So I have a bunch of envelopes here, and I have a couple that I've already started to deconstruct, but I'll talk you through my process. And then some things to tuck in to the envelopes. So this is just a new little one. It has a little pocket here, and I got this to put in it, like a little bookmark that I made out of these Loteria boards. They're like a, almost like a bingo set. Oops, somebody's coming in. Okay. So this is the envelope with the window, a little folded area to attach to a page, and then a pocket. And then this one, I think I may have shown you last week. This is a bigger one, and it has a tag inside, so you can see it through the window. You could use that, you know, for journaling, or, you know, for a little gift card or something like that. And then I got really into the idea of making something like just a little pocket all by itself, which can then hold, you know, like a tiny book or something like that, if you wanted to give that as a gift. And then you could just glue it into a page in your journal and have that. And then this was actually the easiest one. I just took some scrapbook paper on the outside, and this is just the envelope, and then I glued something on the inside. So this one you would just have, like, you could probably put some washi tape here and have it flip up out of a journal page, or here. But this one doesn't have a tab, so this could also just be where you would put a message or a gift or something like that. So I'll talk about these others in a little while, but I'm going to show you how to make this type that has this flap that would attach into a journal. Okay, so the first thing you need, of course, is an envelope with a window. And so I have a bunch of them here. They just look, they're called security envelopes, but they often will also have a window. And when we cut them, be sure to save the insides, because this, you can use it for all kinds of collage papers, and it's just an interesting pattern. And they're all different, if you see what I mean. And when you start matching them up and putting them together in a collage, they do make for some interesting patterns. So, but we're going to just take one of these envelopes, and I've already started on this one. This is what it looked like before. Okay, people are coming in here. Okay. Welcome, everybody who's just arrived. I'm just starting to show how to make these cool little journal pocket envelopes out of security envelopes. So the first thing you want to do is deconstruct it. And you can either do that by tearing along here, or you can get your scissors and just cut. You take the flap off and just cut it open like that. Okay. And what you'll need to keep is part of this piece, or you can, if you want it smaller, then you can just cut this whole piece off, and we'll make a little flap out of this side, and then we'll be folding up the bottom to make the pocket. So for this one, I'm going to just cut this right down the middle. And sometimes, for me anyway, it's easier to just use an X-Acto blade. I have my handy dandy Olfa, O-L-F-A knife, which is my my X-Acto blade of choice. One of the things I really like about it is it comes with all these extra blades, and you just pop one off and then you have a fresh blade. And for anyone who works with bookmaking, you know how blunt these things can get. So one where you can keep replacing the blades is handy. So now we're left with this, and I would fold over maybe about a half an inch or so on this side, kind of like that. You can measure if you want, or you can just sort of have a go at folding it like that. Get your bone folder and smooth it out. If you don't have a bone folder, you know, you can use the handle of your scissors or your fingernail, credit card. So now we have the basis of our flap. And now we want to make the pocket. So we're going to fold up this part, just either right up to the line of the envelope, or you could even go a little further and then fold this back to have a little extra strength. I'm going to do that, just fold that a little bit. And then we're going to fold that up to that line. So now we have a fold here. We have a fold here and here. So now we need to cut this little rectangle piece off. It's a little hard to see. Maybe it's easier to see on the white side. We're going to cut this piece here. I'll outline it. So it's this rectangle here. Just cut that out. And you might need to angle it a little bit, but we'll see how it looks before we do that. Okay, so this is going to come up like that. And you might want to just cut a little notch. Yes, you'll do it on this part like this. It's going to be like this, right? That's just the basic design of this cool little pocket. That's exactly what this was. You can see the similarities. The flap, the inside, the pocket. And honestly, the rest is up to you. I collaged this with different kinds of vintage papers. That's a shorthand book. This was a page out of a book that I watercolored. This is an old ledger, the old ledger again on this side. And then just some, jelly printed papers. But I'm not gonna decorate mine today, although I could, because I did bring a whole bunch of papers. Now, if you don't want it to be so busy, feel free to just paint it with acrylics, or you know, find some scrapbook paper that's, you know, soothing to the eye, if that's what you're going for. And you can just cover the whole thing with something like this. The thing is, because of the window, we do need to kind of measure pieces so that they will fit. So for instance, you know, I might want to put this along the top, and then I'll have things down the sides. I can't just cover it, because then it would defeat the purpose of having that window. And then for this part, you're going to use either a glue stick or a tape roller. This is a Tombow refillable. You can take them apart and put a new cartridge in, which I like. And to begin with, I'm just going to glue down this little flap so it sort of gets out of my way. They're real sticky, which is great. And they're not messy, which is also great. And then we're just going to glue the two sides. We obviously want to leave that top. You can wait to do this until after you've decorated it, which might be easier to decorate. Or you can just get it started by doing this. And then you have your pocket already, you know, so you know what size thing, if you want to put something in it, just need to trim that. And that's really what you have. The rest is, like I say, you could even leave this design and you could add in some more of it and just, you know, have it be a security envelope design. Or you can use some, you know, kind of vintage music. I have a ton of paper. So, you know, I have lots of choices here, but if you don't, you can just grab some packaging paper if you get boxes from Amazon or anything like that and just cover it. You can crumple up that packing paper and then flatten it out, glue it down, and then just rub over the top of the texture with maybe some gold paint on your finger or some kind of color. And then you can make it really cool looking, like it looks almost like leather. So I'm just going to pause the recording for a moment. So this is the very basic format for a little pocket that can go inside of a journal. Let's say this is junk journal and I want to put it on a page. I could just add it to this page by gluing or using that nice double-sided tape, and I can just add it to this page. If I could make it open, glue this here, then we might want to put something, you know, kind of interesting underneath it so that when you open it, you know, you see something. Or you could just use, you know, one of these tags or whatever you have in the pocket, like this. It would open like that. You could see that. And then when you open it, you see that it's a tag. Anyway, that there's all kinds of possibilities for putting it in a book that you've made or a journal that you're using. But I just wanted to share with you a couple of these other techniques for using up these envelopes, because so many of them end up in the landfill or the recycle, and they don't need to because there's so many different things you can do with them. So I think the next thing is I want to show you how to make this little pocket, and I'm sure actually that a lot of you could just figure it out if you looked at this, but I'm just going to show you real quick. Now this has a big pocket, so an envelope like this, excuse me, wouldn't probably, well, you could do it, but, oh, look at that one has two, you could do that. Or you can use one of these, the post office has these free priority mail envelopes and they're just so cool. They're thick. So the other thing you can do with something like this, and I think I cut this down to size. Yeah, this is just a piece from a calendar I had. And I would just do something like that, you know, and then decorate this, glue this into the page, and then you can open it and have this little surprise to come out. I think that's really cool. The other thing I did, which I think you saw, was I just covered the whole outside with one type of scrapbook paper, and I covered just one side of the inside with another. This was an image from a catalog of some sort, and then you could just use this in your journal or to send in a letter. The gluing of this part was the tricky part because it kept wanting to stick. So you just have to really get it down to the bottom pretty carefully. Okay, so for this one, I don't want to use that one. Here's another good one. Here's a good one. If you have a financial advisor who gets a lot of mail, I ask my guy to save all these for me because they're just putting them in the recycle. So a lot of these envelopes are just from him, and they're happy to get rid of them. You just have to show up and pick them up. Okay, so this one, you just, again, you deconstruct it however you want to. This one might need scissors. So you just cut away half of it, basically. Cut away the part that doesn't have the pocket. Okay. And then we're going to cut along here. I'm going to do that with my blade again. Just either that or you could even tear it like this. When you tear it with a ruler, you push down on the ruler and you pull the paper towards the ruler and towards yourself. I don't know if I'll save Raymond James. I guess I could use some of the letters, so maybe I will save that. And then we're going to get rid of this part too. And now this was a smaller pocket, but actually it was bigger, but I cut it and then I put some washi tape down there. So I would do that probably with this one too. I might do something like this. And just trim this part. Right, that doesn't look very good there, does it? So I want to bring that over a little further, or I'll use washi tape again. And then you can decide how big or small you want that top part. One of the things I like to do pretty often is to make a little thumb space. And what I do is get something round, and you can use a hole punch, but I don't have one of those. So I will use, let's see, this candle and just trace around it and then cut it out. And that'll give me, is that the right way? Yeah. That'll give me a place to sort of grab whatever's inside. And again, you'll paint or collage or otherwise decorate this little envelope pocket. Now I would put some kind of collage paper on the inside before I do anything else, because you're going to see that in there. So I would do that. Glue that down here. You don't need to decorate this because it's getting glued. And then you want to decorate the rest. And then if you have washi tape or other kind of tape, all of you probably know that I am a washi tape aficionado. And so I would, after I decorated, I would tape along the bottom in here. And then I have a little pocket that this pocket could fit inside of. Where's that little book? Anyway, here, excuse me, this is made from one sheet of paper. Some of you have seen that video, you know, just some little book like that. Okay, so I hope you've enjoyed this little lesson. My lessons are usually between 20 and 30 minutes, and I hope you've enjoyed watching it. And I'm going to stop the recording and chat to the people who are here. So thank you.